was easy. If it was you leaving with Scott, the hope was high.
Hi.
Hello.
Because I want to be together.
We be together.
I love you, George.
Oh,
George.
Trying.
Come on, I love you. Tell me you love me, please.
Okay.
I love you, George.
I love you. Love you, George.
How can you miss someone you've never met? I need you now, but I don't know you yet. But can you find me soon, because I'm in my head. Yeah, I need you now, but I don't know you yet.
Memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ribs.
There came no explanation or answers about why one day, at the end of July, both in 1970 and 2020, a phone call had been so powerful enough to break time. Neither George nor Clay had gone looking for any or told anybody. The phone calls, however unexplainable and impossible, and all of their contents were still their little secrets. The calls may have defied every law of time and space there was, but it was no match for how much it had changed two young men's lives. The connection of those two hearts was stronger than the magic that brought them together. So however painful and tragic the end of this story became to, now you know that once upon a time, in the same room of the same house, 50 years apart, Clay and George Davidson had loved each other.
One day a man from 1970 gave me a call. He had dirty blonde hair and compared to me he's pretty tall. He had lime green eyes and bigger hands I wish that I could hold. And we'd spend late in the evening talking on the telephone. He's so full of himself and he likes making sadistic jokes. But there's something that I'm so in love with in the way he spoke. And the way he draws, the way he sings along to his guitar. If only the distance between us wasn't so that goddamn far. When I'm talking to him, that's the happiest I'll ever be. And he makes me feel so special, I love it whenever he compliments me, tries to hide the fact that he's obsessed with me. Went through trouble sending me flowers from 1970. One day a man from 1970 gave me a call. Now my only memories of him are handprints on the wall. And that faded green paint, three familiar words were written under. Once upon a time, same room, same house, 50 years apart, we had loved each other.
Come on.
Motherfucker, dude.
Yes!
Nice car.